Hello, and welcome to another Scriptcase tutorial. My name is Nate Carpenter, and today we're going to be looking at using multiple languages in one project, one application inside of Scriptcase. So I have here an application set up for languages, and it's already set up, so I'm not going to show you how to develop it. But let's look at our database for this first. So let's go up to Database and Database Builder, so you can see kind of how this is laid out. We have two database connections, a security database, which we'll use in another video, and then a cuss database. The cuss database is what we're concerned about, so we'll click on that. And this is a database for managing a film inventory here. So we have all these tables here, you can see them, and our security tables too. But we're going to focus in on this actor table right here. Let me click on that actor table. And it's just a very simple table with an ID that's auto-increment, name, all that information. So let's go back to our applications here, and as you can see, we have a grid and a form for actor, as well as a menu. And then we have a security system set up as well. This is the standard security module with Scriptcase. Let's go ahead and run our login application so we can log in here, and I can show you how this works. So we're going to be changing this login page here, but let's log in here. Let me type in my credentials. Click sign in, and here is our menu, just a very basic menu, nothing too complicated here. We have our security menu here, and that is there, and then our actors here. There's our grid of all of our actors. And then if we click edit on one of those, we can go to the form side of that. So that's to edit that or to add a new one. So that is our application that we're going to be using to set up this languages system in. So in order to use multiple languages, we have to edit all these text items here, the titles, the buttons, the labels, all of those, so that they can be switched out whenever the languages are switched by the user. Now, Scriptcase provides a lot of tools for us to do that. But first, we need to add a new language to our project. So we go to Project here and then Properties. These are the properties for this project. And we need to go to Locales right here, this tab. We have English set up already. That's the default, and we could delete it if we wanted. And then we can add a new one here. We're going to add Spanish to this. So let me search the drop-down here, there's Spanish. And then we can add a specific dialect of Spanish to that. So we have all these different ones, and you could add as many languages and as many dialects as you want. Let's leave it on Spanish Spain. And there's a little menu about our application languages area, which I'll show you in a second of how that works. So let's go ahead and hit save on this, and now we have a second language added to our project. Now we have all those different little items that we need to edit, but Scriptcase actually makes this a lot more streamlined for us. A lot of those are going to be built in already. And then we have a way to add in any ones that we would like as well. Let's go ahead and open this actor application here. This is the form. Just as an example, once that opens up here, let's go to edit fields. And here we have the field labels here. And so those are in English right now. And we need to make those into language indexes so that they can be swapped out, whether it's English or Spanish. So we need to go to data dictionary here. And this is going to set up the metadata associated with that table. So we need to define that, set the connection that it's associated with, and then we can create the data dictionary. And if this doesn't make sense, I'll show you how it works here, and it'll make a little more sense. So these are all the tables in our database here. And we're just going to check the box next to actor here. That's that actor table that we're concerned about. Let's check that. And then we need to add that table to our dictionary. So click next on that over here on the left. And we're going to generate the language files for that. And we're going to overwrite anything that already exists in case we already created some stuff. Just like that, and then we can click add down at the bottom. Okay, so there's our table that we've now added to our data dictionary. And we see here it has a label already here in the curly braces. That's an index for our language. And we'll look at how to edit those, but let's click edit on this table now. And we see here the labels for all those fields. These are the labels that are going to be set up in our application by default. And then we can define those for different things for different languages. We can also set some other settings here for that as well if you want to do that. We explore that some more in some other videos. But we're mostly concerned about the labels for today's video, and that's going to be set up in the application languages area here. So we can go to Locales, application language, or it's on that main toolbar as well. So let's click on that. And this is where we define all the values for the different language variables inside of Scriptcase. So we've got two different areas. We've got the main area with the Scriptcase messages and then the project messages. The Scriptcase messages come by default. And as you can see, if I click on one of those, we've got values for both English and Spanish already set up. That comes built in to Scriptcase. So these are the buttons here that you would see on a form or a grid. And those are already set up, built into Scriptcase. We don't have to do anything with those since that language is supported by Scriptcase. But we need it to work for the form labels as well. And that's going to be under project messages. We see there our table actor. And so here are the values for those different items in the different languages. So let's go ahead and set up the English side of this. So make that ID, going to make this first name with nice proper case letters. And now last name. And then last update. So change that one here. Okay, so now that the English side of that is done, I'm going to edit the Spanish side and I'll come back in just a second and they'll be all changed. Okay, here we are. We've made it so now it works in Spanish as well. And if you look here, we have a blank line. We could add a new index if we wanted. We can make it whatever we wanted and add the English value and the Spanish value. And I did that under the general tab right here. I added a few others that we're going to use on our login application. And I'll show you where we use those in a minute, but I just want you to see those and you know where I'm getting them from. So now let's open our actor form again. And we'll go to edit fields. And if I click edit fields here, you see that it's not actually using those indexes that we set up. And that's because we need to synchronize this table, this application, with our data dictionary so that it uses those values there. So we need to go back to data dictionary here. Click our ling, that's our data dictionary created. Check that table right there. And we need to synchronize the applications with that data dictionary table. So right over here on the left, if we click next on synchronize applications, and we need to tell it what we need to synchronize. We could synchronize all the properties for all those applications there, but really we're just concerned about label over there on the right for both the form and the grid. So make sure label is checked and make sure both the form and the grid are checked and then click synchronize. It'll give us a little log making sure everything is okay. And then that's all synchronized. So let's go back to our form. Let's reload the edit fields area. And there we go. Now the label is set up using that language variable that we set up over in the application languages area. And that's going to be the same for the grid. If we go to the grid and click edit fields right there. It also is using those variables there. So now those labels are going to be set up to use the different languages, and we can click generate on those just to make sure they're all set up and the code is generated. So generate the code for that. And once that is done, now we just need to add a few more that aren't set up automatically by the data dictionary. The main one there is the menu item. So we go to menu items. Our security side of this is already set up. Since that was set up with the security module, it's already using those language variables. We just need to edit it for the actor option on that menu there. So that just says actors in English. And we added something over in the application languages for this. So let's go back to application languages here. And it's this one right here, this lang form actor. That's going to give us actor in both English and Spanish. So let me copy that there. Copy that index. Okay, so it's copied. Go back to menu, and I just need to put it right in there in that text area. So put the curly braces around it so that Scriptcase knows it's the language variable. And then generate the source on that menu. And that's all set up to work for us now. So now that all of our variables are set up to control whether or not the correct text is used for the language, we just need to set up the mechanism by which we can switch languages. And that's going to be done in the login application. Okay, so here's our login application. And this is just a basic login application with one of the default login templates here. And we're going to include some buttons on here. We're also going to change the layout here to change languages on this. So to do that, we need to edit this login application, but we need to change the template. So we're going to go to Tools, External Libraries, and in there we have some different templates for our login application. So we have our samples one by default. That's where the current template is from. But we're going to go down here. I have a lot of libraries here, but we're going to go to this languages library right here. So let's click edit on that. And all of this code in the project will be made available in the link in the description below. And we see here some files, some different files here. And we have two images here, one for Spanish and one for English. And if we click on one of those, let me click on the English one here. It's going to show a little flag for the country of origin there. So it's really small, but we use that in the template. And then what we're concerned about is this index.html file. And here we have those language settings that we set up there. The description of the login, and then we also are bringing in the CSS file that's also in there. You can look at that if you want. And then there's a background image, and we'll see that once we load the page. We have the title, the description again, and then the text for the download link as well. And so it's using those curly braces, just like before, to use those application language variables there. There's our welcome text. And then we have an area here to set up those flags with different links in it. So it's just going to call us back around to our login application when they click on those images there. And when they click on them, it'll pass through that get variable telling us which language they selected right there. So the lang either equals ES or EN for Spanish or English. And then we have some more items here for the username and for the password as well as placeholders for that. And then lastly, we have our submit button down here with the submit text there, and then some links if we wanted to include those. We're not going to use those today so much. But let's click cancel on that. So that's all set up. Now we need to use it in our login application. So let's go ahead and edit our login application. And we see here it's using that login for template. That's in the default Scriptcase samples library. We're going to go into our public library and scroll down and find our languages library here. We scroll down and here it is, right there. Let's click and expand that. And we should see that index file. There it is. Click on that. And then we can run it here. And as you can see, we have a new look of our login system, our login page here. And we have those different items there. And if we click one of those, it's going to reload it with the new get variable pass through there. But nothing is actually happening yet. But you can see it's passing through those variables. And now we just need to add a little bit of code so that it knows what to do with those different variables. So back in our login application, we're going to go to events on application init right here. This is the first event that gets called. There's a little bit of code right there. And let me copy in just a little bit and I'll explain how this works. Okay. So let me add a line here. So the first thing it does is it checks the header to determine what language the browser thinks we're in. So we look at that. And if it's set to Spanish, then we're going to use the SC set language macro. And that's just going to change the language for the current session. You can see the documentation for that in the Scriptcase documentation. And then it's going to look at the get variable. So that's that lang variable right there at the end of the URL. It's going to make sure it's set and it's not empty. And if those things are true, then we'll just have the switch just like we saw before. And if it's Spanish, we'll set it to Spanish. If it's English, we'll set it to English. And that'll set it for the entire session of when the user's logged in. So all the other applications will know which language we're in. Let's go ahead and run this and see if it works. Okay, so it's loaded here. Let's go ahead and click on the Spanish one. And there we go. Now we're in Spanish. All the text is swapped out for the Spanish version of this. We can switch it back to English. And now we're back in the English side of this. Let's change it back to Spanish and log in and see if it also works on all of our applications. So let's log in here. And if you can see, the top menu is now in Spanish as well. All those menu items are in Spanish. Let's click that. And the title of it and the buttons as well as the field labels are all in Spanish as well. So that swapped it out. It's no longer in English. If we edit the form, it's the same way. So now everything is in Spanish. And if we logged out and logged back in with English, it would swap it back to English. So I hope that's helpful for you, and I hope you can set up this in your own applications to use multiple languages very easily to allow your users to use your applications in multiple languages. I'll see you in the next tutorials.